Hi friends, here we are on this Thursday of Holy Week, and I think today is when you feel it most, because the sense of isolation, because we would have been joined together tonight with our friends from St John's to share a meal and then share in the sacrament of communion as we followed and continued in our Holy Week journey. But here we are in this different setting, doing something completely different from what we'd normally do. And we're going to continue to read from John's Gospel. And what's interesting about John is he sets a different pattern from the other Gospel writers. Matthew, Mark and Luke follow the traditional pattern that we would recognise of the Last Supper in the upper room and then going on to Gethsemane and all that followed after that. Whereas John sets a very different pattern indeed. We're going to pick up reading from John chapter 13 and verses 31 through to the end of the chapter. Jesus predicts Peter's denial. When he was gone, Jesus said, "Now is the Son of Man glorified, and God is glorified in him. If God is glorified in him, God will glorify the Son himself and will glorify him at once. My children, I will be with you only a little longer. You will look for me, and just as I've told the Jews, so I tell you now, where I'm going, you cannot come. A new commandment I give to you, love one another as I have loved you, so you must love one another. By this all men will know you're my disciples, if you love one another." Simon Peter asked him, "Lord, where are you going?" Jesus replied, "Where I'm going, you cannot follow me, but you will follow later." Peter asked, "Lord, why can't I follow you now? I will lay down my life for you." Then Jesus answered, "Will you really lay down your life for me? I tell you the truth, before the cock crows, you will disown me three times." This important reading is important for two reasons. First of all, the commandment that's given, love one another. We'll come back to that in a second. But then also Peter's denial. And of course, when we pick up the rest of the recognisable narrative of Easter and Holy Week, that is when we pick it up when Jesus is being arrested, he's being betrayed by Judas, and then, of course, Peter denies Jesus three times. We know, of course, that the reason for that is so that Peter can be rehabilitated by Jesus post-resurrection when he asks, "Do you love me?" three times. But I think the most important part in this narrative of John and this chapter of John is this one commandment. I give you my new commandment. Love one another as I have loved you. It seems so simple, doesn't it? But it's not easy at times to love people. It's not easy to love people who hurt you. It's not easy to love people who ignore you. It's not easy to love people who cause you pain and hurt. And yet that's what we're called to do. We're called to love. Not to judge, not to exclude, but to love. No ifs, buts or maybes, just love. And that's the great message of Maundy Thursday. Great message of Easter, the great message coming from the scripture. Love one another, be there for each other. And in this time of difficulty, in this time of pain, in this time of uncertainty, make that love known to all whom you share your journey with. My friends, on this very different Maundy Thursday, may God bless you and be with you. May he continue to guide you and guard you, and may you know the love of Christ in your hearts today and always. And at 8 o'clock, as you maybe take the opportunity to stand in your front door and give celebration to those who are at the front line putting their lives at risk for us, know that that is an act of love, just as saying hello to the people next door or asking if you can help. Be there for each other. Love one another. And in that love, then Christ will be seen and Christ will be known. Let's pray for a moment. Lord, help us to love. Help us to be the conduits through which your love is known and shared. Help us to be seen to be your children. Not just seen to be, but to be your children. By living out your faith, by living out your love in all the ways that we can. Bless us, our family and friends. Bless all within our congregation, our town and community this day. Bless all who put their lives in front of others in keeping us safe, especially those working in difficult times. And Lord, may we know that peace in our hearts, that love that overcomes all human pain, that love that is your Son's gift to us. In your name, O Lord. Amen. My friends, wherever you are, stay safe this day, and thank you for being you.